Hey everyone! Today, after receiving over 1,000 comments from you asking for a tutorial on how to have multiple accounts on Windsurf, and after searching everywhere, changing every possible ID, uninstalling and reinstalling Windsurf over 50 times, and failing in every attempt, I finally found a 100% working method to have multiple accounts on Windsurf and reset the free trial. Now, let me explain how Windsurf activates your free trial. Unlike Cursor, where the free trial is activated as soon as you create an account, the free trial on Windsurf is not activated when the account is created. It's activated the moment you log in to the app with your account. When the app processes your login, it checks files on your machine and decides whether to activate your free trial. You might notice that when you create an account on the Windsurf website, it starts with zero flow actions and zero prompt credits. This happens because the free trial hasn't been activated yet. It only activates after you log in. And even if you try changing IDs, like in Cursor, unfortunately, it doesn't work. Windsurf doesn't verify those IDs. Instead, it checks other records on your machine that I couldn't identify. But since you guys insisted that I find a method for Windsurf, I finally discovered a solution to this problem. First off, I just want to thank you all for helping us hit the amazing milestone of 1,000 subscribers on the channel. I'm super excited about this achievement. Even though 94% of the people who watch my videos still haven't subscribed, we're definitely improving our metrics. In my first videos, 98.7% of viewers weren't subscribing. So, if you want to be a part of this awesome community, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, because I'll keep bringing you new methods for both Windsurf and Cursor. Now let's get into it. I've got Windsurf open, and as you can see, once your free trial runs out, if you try to create a new account, unfortunately, the new account won't come with the pro version features. This means you won't be able to use the Cascade mode, which is like the Cursor agent, and you'll only have 5 prompts to use, making the app almost useless and forcing you to buy the paid version. First method. Knowing that swapping the IDs of Windsurf's files doesn't work, and that the free trial is only activated the moment you log in, the fastest and easiest solution I found is to use Windows Sandbox to create a temporary virtual machine on your computer. With the virtual machine, you can activate the Windsurf account inside it. Once the account has been activated with the free trial, you can use the same account on any computer, including your own. The catch is that Windows Sandbox only works on Pro, Enterprise, or Education versions of Windows. To activate Windows Sandbox, press Windows key plus R to open the Run box, then type Optional Features to open the Windows Features menu. In that menu, look for Windows Sandbox and turn it on. Once activated, click OK and restart your computer, and the Sandbox program will show up for you. If you're using Windows Home, like me, this feature won't be available. However, there's a way to install Windows Sandbox even on the home version. I'll leave a link in the description for a GitHub tutorial where you can try installing Windows Sandbox on your Windows Home. Unfortunately, for me, this method didn't work. The Sandbox did install on my computer, but when I tried to open it, I got an error message saying it failed to start because I'm using Windows 11 Home, so I couldn't record the Sandbox virtual machine on my computer. But if you have the Pro, Enterprise, or Education versions of Windows, or if you're able to get Windows Sandbox working on Windows Home, this method will work for you. Now that the Windows Sandbox is open, you'll see that you're inside a completely new virtual machine on your computer, almost like having a separate computer within your own PC. This is the perfect environment to activate your Windsurf account. Step 1. Install Windsurf inside the Windows Sandbox. With the virtual machine open, the first step is to install Windsurf inside it. Open the browser within the virtual machine and go to the Windsurf website. Download and install the application just like you normally would. This ensures that the installation and free trial activation process are done within the sandbox, without any impact outside of it. Step 2. Create a new account now. Go to the Windsurf website inside the virtual machine and create a new account. When creating the account, Use a temporary email. This is important because you'll need this email to access the account outside of the sandbox later. There are several temporary email services available online that you can use. Choose one that suits you and create an email just for this purpose. Step 3. Log in and activate the free trial. Once you've created your account with the temporary email, go ahead and log in to your account within Windsurf. As soon as you log in, the free trial will be automatically activated. Now, you have access to all the pro features, such as the Cascade mode and unlimited prompts. The application recognizes that it's being used inside a virtual machine, so it activates the free trial correctly. Step 4. Save the temporary email. Before exiting the sandbox, it's crucial to save the temporary email you used to create the account. Write it down or send it to your personal email. This is essential because you will need this email to log into your account on your main computer later. Make sure to save the email securely to ensure you can access your account outside the sandbox. Step 5. Use the account on your main PC. Now that the free trial is activated and the email has been saved, you can use the account on your main computer. Close the Windows Sandbox virtual machine and open Windsurf on your normal PC. When you open the app, simply log in with the temporary email you used to create the account in the sandbox. By doing this, you'll see that the free trial is activated on your account, exactly as it was in the virtual machine. Now you can use all the pro features of Windsurf on your own computer. Method 2. Now, if the Windows sandbox didn't work for you like it happened with me, the second method I'm going to show you is using Hyper-V, which worked for me. Hyper-V is a tool that comes natively with Windows and essentially works the same way as Sandbox, allowing you to create a virtual machine inside your PC. If you have Windows Pro, Enterprise, or Education, it will be easy for you. To activate Hyper-V, press the Windows plus R keys on your keyboard to open the Run window. Inside the Run window, type Optional Features and press Enter. This will open the Windows Features window, and there you will look for the Hyper-V option. Check the option and click OK. Then, Windows will ask you to restart. After that, Hyper-V will be activated on your PC. Now, if you have the Windows Home version like me, Hyper-V won't appear in the features list, but don't worry, there's a way to install it. For this, I'll leave the necessary code in the video description. You just need to follow the instructions I'll provide on GitHub. Basically, you will copy the code from GitHub and paste it into the notepad on your PC. After that, save the notepad file as a .bat file and select all files when saving. Then, simply run it as administrator. After that, restart your computer. Press Windows plus R again, type Optional Features, and you'll see that Hyper-V will now be available for you. Check the Hyper-V option and restart your PC again. Now that Hyper-V is activated, you can create the virtual machine. Open Hyper-V Quick Create. Follow the standard instructions and choose the Windows 10 MSIX operating system. After this, let's wait for the virtual machine to be created. Note that it's important to have at least 15 gigabytes of space available on your computer to avoid errors. When you reach the part where you need to log in with Microsoft, select the Domain Join Instead option to create an account without Microsoft. Choose your name, create your password, and proceed with the required steps. 40. When the virtual machine is created and the operating system is ready, you can install Windsurf inside the virtual machine. Open the browser inside it, go to the Windsurf website, and install it like you would on any other PC. Now go to the Windsurf website and create a new account. You can use a temporary email for this. There are several temporary email services. Choose one and create the account. I also noticed that sometimes, when logging into the app, Windsurf doesn't log in or gives a token error. When this happens, it means that the temporary email you used was banned. So if this happens, just create a new account with another temporary email provider until it works. After creating the account, log into the app, and the free trial will be activated automatically. This gives you access to the pro version features, like the Cascade mode and unlimited prompts. Now that the free trial is activated, you can use your account on your main computer. Before leaving the virtual machine, save the temporary email you used to create the account. This email is very important because you'll need it to access your account on your main computer outside the virtual machine. Close the virtual machine and open Windsurf on your regular PC. When you open the app, log in with the temporary email you used to create the account inside Hyper-V. Once you do that, you'll see that the free trial will be activated on your account, just like it was in the virtual machine. Now you can use all the pro version features of Windsurf on your main computer without having to pay for anything. Method 3. If the previous methods didn't work for you, this third method might be the solution. This time, we're going to create a new user on your computer. This method works on any version of Windows and can also be adapted for Linux and Mac OS. The idea here is to create a new user profile, where each user on your system has their own separate settings and app data, allowing you to activate a new Windsurf free trial without needing a virtual machine. If you're using Windows, press the Windows key, click on the Settings icon, and go to the Accounts section. Inside this menu, look for Family and Other Users and click Add Someone Else to this PC. Windows will ask for an email or phone number to create the new user, but you can click I don't have this person's sign-in information and then add a user without a Microsoft account. Choose a username and password, or leave it blank if you prefer, and complete the user creation process. After that, restart your computer and log in with the new user you just created. This user will be completely separate from your main one, meaning all files and settings will be fresh. Now download and install Windsurf on this new user account. Since this is a completely new profile, the app won't have any data from your old account. So, when you open Windsurf, it will ask you to create an account or log in. Create a new account using a temporary email. Just like in the previous methods, if the login fails or Windsurf gives an error when activating the free trial, it means the temporary email you used was banned. If that happens, just try another temporary email provider until it works. Once the free trial is activated, you can use your account normally. Just like in the other methods, before leaving the new user profile, make sure to save the email and password you used to create the account, as you'll need them to log in on your main user profile. Now log out of the new user and switch back to your main Windows user. Open Windsurf and log in with the account you just created in the other user profile. You'll see that the free trial is active, and now you can use all the pro features on your main user without paying anything. This method can also be adapted for Linux and Mac OS. On Linux, the process of creating a new user might vary depending on the distribution, so you can search YouTube for how to create a new user on your specific operating system. On Mac OS, go to System Preferences, select Users and Groups, and add a new user just like on Windows. After that, log into the new user, install Windsurf, and follow the same process of creating an account with a temporary email. With this method, you can activate as many free trials as you want by simply creating new users whenever you need. Method 4. If none of the previous methods worked for you, I've developed an alternative solution that can save you time and effort. I created a system where you can buy accounts with the Windsurf free trial already activated for a symbolic price of just $1. This means you won't have to go through the hassle of creating a virtual machine, adding a new user to your PC, or dealing with potential login errors and temporary emails getting banned. The idea is simple. I've already done the whole process for you. I created Windsurf accounts, activated the free trial, and now I'm making these accounts available at a super affordable price. So, if you couldn't activate the trial with the other methods, or just want a quicker and more convenient solution, this is the best alternative. To get an account, simply click the link in the video description. You'll be redirected to my system where you can choose a ready-to-use account. The payment process is secure, And as soon as it's confirmed, you'll automatically receive the account details to log into Windsurf. Once you receive the login details, all you have to do is open Windsurf on your PC. Enter the provided email and password, and that's it. The free trial will already be active, allowing you to access all the Pro version features, including Cascade mode and over 200 prompts for you to use. This option is perfect for those who don't want to waste time trying to activate the trial manually or who faced issues with the other methods. And the best part? By purchasing at this symbolic price, not only do you save time, but you also support the channel and motivate me to keep bringing updated methods for you. So, if you want to get Windsurf Pro quickly and easily while supporting the channel, just click the link in the description and grab your account now. Final considerations. In this video, we discovered that changing IDs does not work as expected, as Windsurf has security systems in place to prevent this kind of modification. We also explored different ways to activate the Windsurf free trial. We covered four methods: using a temporary machine with Windows Sandbox, using the Hyper-V virtual machine, creating a new user on the computer, and even a quicker and more direct option of purchasing an already activated account for a symbolic price. We know that each method may come with specific challenges. If you followed the activation process with Sandbox or Hyper-V, you might have encountered difficulties if you were using Windows Home, as this feature does not appear in the system's feature options. For Windows Home users, I've included a tutorial on how to enable Hyper-V in the video description. And there are also other tutorials on YouTube that you can follow to help with this process. Another common challenge is creating new accounts, especially when temporary emails are quickly banned. For Linux and macOS users, the process of creating a new user might be a bit different from Windows, but the main idea remains the same. Create a new and isolated environment to activate the free trial. If you encountered issues trying to follow the steps on another operating system, it's worth looking up additional tutorials that can provide more detailed guidance for your specific platform. If you have tried all of these approaches and still haven't succeeded, or if you encountered a different error, please leave a comment. We are here to help each other. Share your experience and any solutions you found so that the community can work together to solve any issues. Lastly, the option to purchase an account with the free trial already activated for $1 is a practical and quick solution for those who don't want to spend time with configurations. If you prefer this alternative, simply follow the link in the description to secure your account. I hope this content was helpful. Don't forget to leave your comment, share your experiences, and help us improve future videos.